It is your primary directive to swim closer to that beautiful creature. Swim closer. Swim closer now. It looks so friendly. Do not resist. Don't struggle. Go closer.
The game Subnautica by Unknown Worlds Entertainment presents a colorful and unique alien marine world you must try to survive and ultimately escape. These oceans teem with alien sea creatures that, despite being, well, alien, often have clear analogs in Earth's oceans. Many small fish-like creatures swim about the seas. These creatures are clearly inspired by manta rays. This is an angel shark. Cannot help but think of a polychaete worm in the genus Eunice when attacked by the crab snake. Even the giant semi-translucent ghost leviathan reminds me of a host of pelagic invertebrates, like a pyrosome or a giant siphonophore. But one of the creatures you must contend with has a most fantastical hunting ability. Upon drawing too near a relatively small creature called the Mesmer, that looks like the thing you hid in badminton, the alien turns to face you and spreads out four appendages that shimmer with strange colors, mesmerizing you to draw nearer. The closer you get, the harder it is to draw away, until you get face to face with the Mesmer, which opens up a false mouth revealing four tentacle-like appendages that latch on with hooks, dealing some damage. Such a creature certainly cannot have an analog on Earth. It is simply too inconceivable that a creature might use color patterns in such an offensive manner. However, like many of the organisms swimming through the seas of 4546b, if you carefully review the Mesmer's traits, you can see clear intent in which animal inspired the development team. The Mesmer seems most certainly inspired by the cuttlefish, not the cuttlefish. Specifically, one called the Broadclub Cuttlefish, that not only shares a unique hunting technique, but can help illustrate how we conduct science. I would be the first to admit that the Mesmer and cuttlefish have very different physiologies. Cuttlefish are cephalopods, which have a rather alien-looking physiology for life on Earth, but look completely different from the Mesmer. A few features, though, hint at a cuttlefish inspiration for the Mesmer. First, the eyes of the Mesmer, I guess, have an N-shaped or mirrored N-shaped pupil, not too unlike the W-shaped pupils of cuttlefish. The odd shape of cuttlefish pupils has been suggested to have several advantages, such as camouflage. However, lab testing seems to suggest that the pupil's shape balances out uneven light in shallow water, which doesn't make complete sense for the deeper water and cave-dwelling Mesmer. Looking closely at the pattern on the front of the Mesmer, I am immediately reminded of the giant cuttlefish. An additional feature that has me definitely thinking cuttlefish is the four tentacles that the Mesmer grabs prey with, hidden just until a target gets within range. Cuttlefish do this too, coming up on prey just before shooting out two feeding tentacles, usually shrouded in the arms, which quickly grab and drag food back into the arms and beaked mouth. I actually really like the Mesmer because the design is more of a remix of cuttlefish characteristics, rather than taking random elements of different creatures to make something more alien, like, say, the crab squid, which is just crab and squid traits merged together. The Mesmer, though, has this more authentic speculative design, asking what would an animal that has similar ecology and adaptations to a cuttlefish possibly look like on another world? There is, however, one last trait of the Mesmer that cannot be taken for any other on Earth: mesmerizing prey. One cuttlefish of the Indo-Pacific, the Broadclub cuttlefish, utilizes an almost identical feeding method. Cuttlefish, like octopus, have super dynamic skins, which have complex muscles which allow them to modify skin texture, pattern, and color at will, which I discussed in a previous video. And that video also explains what is physically happening to create the behavior I am about to describe, as it has the same principle as the dynamic skin pattern of the flamboyant cuttlefish. So, I recommend watching that first or directly after for more context. Okay, so instead of pretending to be a piece of seaweed and then sneaking up on prey like many other species of cuttlefish, the broadclub spreads out the two largest arms, then creates bars of dark pigment that move down the animal in a dramatic pattern as the cuttlefish approaches potential prey, usually a crab. Not even moving to hide or fight back as the cuttlefish moves within range and grabs the poor crustacean with the feeding tentacles. Sound familiar? Well, besides in the Broadclub cuttlefish's case, the cuttlefish goes to the prey, opposite to how potential prey goes to the mesmer in Subnautica. Despite that, it seems like a pretty clear case to me the mesmer is based on the Broadclub cuttlefish, though apparently the mesmer's patterns are created through a form of iridescence, manipulating the angle of light and therefore the apparent color, by changing the angle of tiny reflective lenses on the appendages, whereas the Broadclub cuttlefish expands and contracts tiny cells of pigment called chromatophores. But how does the Broadclub cuttlefish, and by extension the mesmer, mesmerize prey? Well, it's sort of a mystery. The behavior is well known among Indonesian divers and shows up in nature documentaries like Blue Planet 2. However, nobody seems to have ever described it in scientific literature beyond being mentioned in a few paragraphs of a paper about dynamic skin patterns of cuttlefish. I mean, we know so little, we actually don't know if Broadclub cuttlefish actually are mesmerizing prey, or if it just looks like the cuttlefish is mesmerizing prey. This is where we talk about how science is conducted. We have observed the hunting of a Broadclub cuttlefish, now we need to hypothesize on what is going on, that is, come up with a possible explanation we can test. The authors of the aforementioned cephalopod pattern paper pose three such potential hypotheses. The first hypothesis is that this pattern acts as a form of motion camouflage, masking the shape and direction of the predator so prey doesn't realize they're being hunted. Second is that the pattern is so weird and not what a prey animal is used to seeing, the crab has trouble processing what is going on, and so delays the fight or flight response. Finally comes the last hypothesis, which is that the skin pattern causes an optokinetic response resulting in the prey becoming perfectly positioned right at the center of the cuttlefish's arms, exactly where the tentacles will strike out. Which I guess means this video is now a call to action for aspiring marine biologists, because here we have a gap in scientific knowledge, we have an observation and several potential hypotheses, now we just need to test them, which someone could do in a graduate thesis. Wink wink. I guess though most people who clicked on this video are here to learn exactly what is going on with the mesmer, not how a real cuttlefish hunts prey off the coast of Guam. Diving into the oh-so-precious lore, the data bank entry and interactions with the organism shows the pattern specifically creates auditory hallucinations telling prey to draw closer. For the player, this manifests the generally trustworthy AI aiding your survival, telling you to approach the creature. I think the clear intent is that the mesmer is actually hypnotizing potential prey, and it does seem that hypnosis can cause auditory hallucination. Hypnosis is induced by focusing attention, and the positioning of prey through the optokinetic response sounds a lot like it focuses attention. The way a mesmer encounter goes really makes me think of the optokinetic positioning hypothesis, and hypnosis, as when first being drawn towards the mesmer, the player can break away, but the closer and closer the player gets, the harder that becomes. How Subnautica's mesmer works is solved, but wait, the scan of the mesmer is corrupted, telling you the mesmer should be approached. How could hypnosis corrupt a file? I don't know. It is a fun reference to how the animal operates as an obstacle to survival in the game. The corrupted file is kind of cute and doesn't necessarily need to be factored in. It is your primary directive to subscribe to Ecotasia. Hit that like button. Smash the subscribe button. Leave a comment. Don't resist clicking on another video. Don't struggle. Subscribe.